By the end of this video tutorial, you should be able to compress and password protect a zip file in Windows using 7-zip. Hi, my name is David, and if this is your first time watching my video tutorials and you get any value from the content that you watch, kindly consider subscribing. Zipping files and password protecting them keeps your files secure and away from prying eyes that you don't want to access a particular file. If you want to limit the access of a file, then password protecting it is a good way to ensure that only the people that need to see the files have access to the files. So let us begin here inside Google and search for 7-zip. Search for 7-zip. And 7-zip is a free application. It is open source. And yes, it is available for Windows, Linux, and macOS, and also ReactOS. So I'll just go to the first link here, download 7-zip. And for the purposes of this video, I just need to download 7-zip, this particular version here. It's a 2019-02-21. So let's just click on this, download. It's going to start downloading. It's a small file, just 1 MB. And once it's done, I'll just click on it. And it's going to open up so that we can start installing. Let's just click on yes. I want to install 7-zip on a 64 setup. Just click on install and it's done. Now, once it's done, all we need to do is navigate to the folder with the files that we need to zip and password protect. So let's navigate to that particular folder. And this is a folder that I've named password protect me. So let's say these are sensitive images or documents that you have. So let us begin. Let's just highlight both pictures, right click, and then you'll see 7-zip as an option and with a couple of extra options here. Add to archive, compress an email, add to password protect me.z, that is as the folder with this, compress to password protect me.7z, and email, add to passwordprotectme.zip, compress passwordprotectme.zip and email. So all these are options, but let us just click on add to archive. Now, once you add to archive, you have a couple of different options here. So the archive and where it is going to be located inside the folder called passwordprotectme, and then the archive format. These are just some of the few things that you might need to change. Let's say we want it to save as a zip. So there we have it. And then the next option that we need now to ensure that our file is encrypted or protected is to enter the password. Just ensure you enter a password that you remember so that you are also not locked out from the particular file or folder that you have zipped. Let's just add a simple password. Just a simple password, repeat. And you can decide to see the password if you want to copy it. For example, this one is an easy one. You can just say show password 123 QWERTY. Don't show. And then you can choose an encryption method. Now, by default, I'll leave it as it is. Depending on the method that you choose, then it's going to make it more difficult to crack this particular password. So if you are satisfied with your results, then just click on OK. And your files are going to be zipped. And now we have a new file here. If I right click on it and say 7-zip, open archive, we are going to see this particular file. But if we try to double click on it, then it's going to tell us enter a password. Now, if you have the password, all you need to do is just enter the password and then open up this particular image. And there we have it. It has opened up because we have the password to this particular file. If you also wanted to, let's say, extract these particular files, let's say extract here, you're going to get this confirm to replace. And if you say yes to all, you're going to be prompted to enter a password. If you don't have the password, let's say close, then you're going to get this particular error using an application like WinRAR. So that's it. That's how you can compress and password protect a zip file in Windows using 7-zip. So we've gone from installing 7-zip to compressing our file to password protecting the file and also reviewing if the password is available for our file. Thank you for watching this video and I hope it has been of value to you. Until next time, stay safe and never stop learning. Thank you for watching this video.